Hello and welcome. My name is Michael Fischer and I'm trainer and member of the board of BIVENA. BIVENA is a German education center for sustainable development. I'll try to show you a part of our work and give you a short overview about one of our courses in straw building called Further Training Specialist Straw Build Construction. The aim of this training is that the participants after the completion of the course are able to carry out the straw building work on a straw house according to existing plannings and statics and to plaster or to cover walls and ceilings professionally. This training was developed in a project founded by the ESF on behalf of FASBA, the German Straw Building Association, in the period from 2011 to 2013 by Burkhard Röger and Dietmar Hecken. The FASBA was founded in 2002 and has taken up the course of promoting straw build construction. However, it also quickly became clear that the well-founded training of craftsmen and craftswomen as well as planners is also very important in order to advance this construction method. Since then, BIVENA, in cooperation with FASBA, was offered training once a year. The training and all our courses take place at the Eco Center in Verden, near the River Aller. It is a small town near Bremen, in the very north of Germany. Right next to the Eco Center is also the Center for Sustainable Building of Northern Germany. A five-story building insulated with straw and plastered directly. Here you can also find the exhibition Sustainable Build Experience, which we visit with all our courses. The Center for Sustainable Building of Northern Germany also includes an old tank hall that has been converted into a seminar and practice hall. This is also where all our courses take place. The curriculum includes a modular system with 7 core topics, which in turn are further subdivided. In Unit 1, the introduction and basics to build with straw, we look at the history of straw building, how straw builds are formed, how straw builds become building straw builds, what makes good building straw builds, what types of grains to use, and the benefits of straw building. In Unit 3, the post and beam construction, participants first build a wall element in groups of 3 or 4 people, which they then fill with construction bales in 2 ways. One is on site, meaning the timber frame construction is already in place and the construction straw bales are installed into the standing wall elements at the construction site. The other construction method is fabrication, in which individually wall elements are prefabricated, e.g. in a hole, and then filled with the construction straw builds while lying down. Unit 3 deals with the most original straw construction method, load-bearing straw bale construction. In addition to the theory, the participants also build a small house using this construction method and also practice designing it. Unit 4 deals with the subsequent exterior insulation with straw bales. Here, too, in addition to the theory, different possibilities of external insulation with straw bales are executed. Unit 5 deals with plasters. Here, clay plaster for the inside, as well as lime plaster for the outside, as well as claddings. The participants plaster their wall modules with all 3 layers, leveling layer, base and top layer, using clay and lime. Unit 6 deals with the building physics in straw bale houses, sound, heat, moisture and fire protection, the sustainability of store construction, the design designation, the approval ETA, and the German store building code. Finally, Unit 7 is about profitability and self-reliance in store construction, such as the business plan, advertising and marketing, good communication and self-organizing. If you want to be self-employed in store construction, these are all things you should know. Let us now start at the beginning of the training. The participants start with an exercise, building a small shelter. We like to start with practical exercise and not with theory. Besides the first handling of the store builds, other things, a new togetherness on the construction side is very important to us. Cooperation instead of competition, this exercise is also very well suited for that. In so-called store talk, we deal on the one hand with how store builds are produced, what is important for store construction, how store builds become construction store builds, what make good construction store builds and how I can check this on the construction side, and which type of grains should be used. In addition, it's also practic of tuning builds, EA, ensuring that I have more or less square builds so that I have to stuff less later, and also about various ways of shortening or resuming builds. As a straw bale builder, I have to accept the existing wooden structure on the construction site. So it is important during the further training that the participants gain their experience with wooden construction so that they later know what they have to look for. Between the practical sessions, we are also insert theoretical units again and again, so there is also a nice variety here. For the entire training, the proportions of theory and practice is about 50-50%. Here, architect Dirk Sharma explains the building physics of storehouses to the participants. The straw bales can be installed in two different ways. Here the installation on site, i.e. the wooden post construction is already on the building site and ideally the roof is also ready. So you can store the straw bales inside the house. The second method is that of prefabrication, in which, for example, in a rented hall, the individual wooden modules are filled while lying down. As a person who wears the hat on the construction site, I have to be familiar with the designation of the builds in accordance with the ETA, the European Technical Assessment. As I have to fill in and sign the so-called Certificate of the Procedure of Building Store for Professional Installation. This certificate is then placed in the building files. For this reason, we also deal with this topic in further training. After the straw bales are installed, the so-called finishing work must be carried out, such the installation of the wind stiffening, the triangular strip, or the skirting board. Then the next step concerns the preparatory work for cleaning. First, existing gaps must be plugged with straw before shaving the surface with the edge clippers. Then the plaster supports applied, reed for the inside and soft fiber for the outside. Again and again, when work steps has been completed, each group presents its results to the others, so they are then talked about and discussed in the large group. In an exercise in the seminar room, the participants work out the most important details in small groups. The eaves, the ceiling connection, the foundation and the base array, the window and corner of the building. The plans are then photographed so that they can be shown to the large group via beamer and discussed together. In a short and compact lecture, Robert Habenicht explains to the participants why it is important that the building is airtight and windproof and what can happen if this is not the case. This is then practiced using Windows installation as an example. For this reason, the window reveals have not yet been covered with the plaster base, since the window must be connected to the wooden structure in air and wind-tight manner. The space between the windows and the wooden studs will be stuffed with hem before the foils are applied. Also, the second water-bearing layer is placed under the window seal. In order to learn all this process better, the participants can practice masking on model windows beforehand. Applying the leveling layer with clay and lime. Wall heating and electrics. On the dried and then hard leveling layer are then fixed the pipes for wall heating and also electrical and other installations. Clay and lime base coat. After the leveling layer has dried, the clay and lime base plaster is applied, removed with a squeegee, and the plaster mesh is inverted in. Dirk Sharma's lecture on sustainable building with straw deals not only with qualities and criteria of sustainable building, but also, among other things, with the comparison of building elements and entire houses in terms of their primary energy consumption and global warming potential. However, with all the knowledge about straw construction, is it not yet possible to build up a new business field? For this reason, there's a longer block, self-employment and profitability in straw construction, in which the participants learn everything about marketing, business plans on BMAT, communication and self-organization, partly as a lecture, partly in group work, or also through role plays.